I'm Agent Lee, and today I'm going to show you how to set up your Eero whole home Wi-Fi system. If you've struggled with dead spots or you never seem to have enough bandwidth for all of your devices, Eero is a great solution. You can also customize or expand by adding as many Eeros and Eero beacons as you need. That means Eero can cover any home, no matter the size or layout. Today, I'll be setting up the second generation Eero whole home Wi-Fi system, which includes three Eero devices. Here's what you'll need. The Eero whole home Wi-Fi system, including the power adapter and Ethernet cord that it came with. A smartphone, or you can use a tablet as long as it has cellular data. You'll also need the Eero app already installed, along with the credentials for your Eero account. And finally, you'll need a cable or DSL modem, depending on your internet service and provider. I'll be using a Samsung Galaxy Note 10 Plus, so the steps might be a little different depending on your device. At the end of the video, I'll also be connecting an Amazon Echo Show 8, so you can watch that process. All right, to get started, open the Eero app and log into your account. If you don't have an account yet, you'll need to create one. And here's the tip. Choose a strong password, not one that you've used for other accounts. If you need help choosing a password, we have another Tech Tips video linked in the notes that you should check out. Once you're logged in, tap Get Started and follow the on-screen instructions to start setting up your Eero whole home Wi-Fi system. Depending on your setup, you might have to disconnect from your current wireless network. To do that on my phone, I'll go to Settings, Connections, and then Wi-Fi. The gear icon is my old wireless network, so I'm going to tap Forget. Now, back in the app, tap Start. At this point, it's time to unplug your old modem and router. Once that's done, tap Next. Connect the Ethernet cable from your modem to either port on the back of the Eero. Again, my package has three identical Eero devices, so it doesn't matter which one I choose for this step. When you're ready, tap Next. Now it's time to plug in the Eero using the power cord. Then plug your modem back in. It'll take about 5 minutes to allow your modem and Eero to fully boot up. Once the light on the Eero starts pulsing blue, tap Next in the app. It'll now find your new Eero. If it's not finding it, here's a tip. Make sure the Eero light is pulsing blue. If it's flashing white, it's still booting up and isn't ready to be set up quite yet. If the light is red, there's a problem and it needs to be reset. If the light is solid white, then it's already been set up before and likely needs to be reset. Before you do that, reboot your device and try again. Sometimes that's all you need to do. When the light is pulsing blue, you'll see a message saying your Eero has been detected. Select your location, then name your network and set a password. The name of your network shouldn't be anything personal, like your name or address. You'll be using the name and password to connect your devices, so take a minute to write them down. Your settings will now be applied and your network will be created. When it's ready, you'll see a message like this, confirming that your network has been created. Tap Next. And then, if you need to add more Eero devices, like I do, tap Continue Setup. The app will offer some guidelines and suggestions about outlets and flat space to maximize the reach of your system. For example, your Eero devices should be centrally located, not in an enclosed space, and away from other large electronics to minimize interference. When you're ready to place the other devices, plug in your next one and wait for the light to pulse blue. Then tap Next. The app should find it and display a success message. And the app will now verify that the devices are communicating with each other. If you see, let's try moving it, that's a sign you definitely want to find a better spot. Find a place that works well and then select it. When you do, you'll see a success message, like this. Now, if you have another device like I do, tap Next to set it up the same way. Or if your devices are already set up and good to go, press Finish Setup. Your Eero will automatically install any available updates, which might take a little time. During this process, your devices will reboot. When the update is finished, you'll see another success message, and you can finish the setup by tapping Done. Nice work! You have successfully set up your Eero whole home Wi-Fi system. Before you go, let me walk you through a few more things. First, if you ever want to add any more devices down the road, here's how. Log into the app and tap the plus button in the top right, and then add an Eero device. You can check out some tips in the app or skip to just go right to the setup, which is what I'm going to do. The Eero app will search for the new device and a success page will be displayed when it's found. Then, just like before, select your location and follow the same steps to get it set up and ready to go. Now, let's talk about smart devices. I'll be using an Amazon Echo Show 8, so the steps might be a little different depending on yours. To get it connected, go to Settings, Network, and choose yours. Enter the password, tap Done, and then connect. Oh, and like other Amazon Echo Smart speakers, it'll also ask you to enter your Amazon password. Now, I can see my Amazon Echo Show 8 in my Eero dashboard. Here, you can change device names and types. And here's another tip. Many Eero devices have two active Ethernet ports that can be used to connect devices or connect other Eeros. So if your home is pre-wired for Ethernet, you can use it to make sure your Eeros communicate with each other even further than they could wirelessly. You can run a speed test right from the dashboard. Just tap Internet and run speed test. You can see which devices are connected and even set parental controls. You can even pause the internet with an Alexa command. And of course, you shouldn't have any more issues with bandwidth or dead spots. Hopefully this video was helpful. If it was, give it a like. If you have questions, let us know in the comments. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more tech tips from Best Buy. Thanks for watching.